This is Klaus, and he asks himself, what does the term half-life actually mean? So let's imagine Klaus has a flock of sheep. All of the sheep are very jittery, but after one day, half the flock has calmed down. But be careful, that doesn't mean that by the next day, the whole flock has calmed down. Because after the half-life period of another day, again, only half of the remaining jittery, naughty flock will behave as they should. This continues and so on and so forth, until at some point the entire flock has calmed down. Therefore, in this case, the half-life of the naughty black sheep of the flock would be one day. If half of the sheep became well-behaved not in one day, but in 1 hour, the half-life of the sheep would be exactly an hour. Thus, the flock would also calm down much more quickly. The same also applies to radioactive materials. Radionuclides have a half-life too, during which half of the materials decay. In this process, other radionuclides form, which in turn decay as well. Here too, the period in which exactly half of the material decays is also called half-life. There are materials with very short half-lives, so these decay very quickly, for example, in a few milliseconds. Other radioactive materials have half-lives of several million years or even much longer. Anyway, Klaus's sheep have all calmed down, and now he's looking forward to enjoying some delicious sheep's cheese.